Bluehost WordPress tutorial for beginners step by step. Hey guys, Brian with WP Cupid Blog, and in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to start and set up a WordPress site step by step. Whether you're a newbie at technology or a pro, this step by step Bluehost WordPress tutorial for beginners will be perfect for you. The great thing about this tutorial is it is extremely easy to follow along with, even if you have no experience in setting up and starting a WordPress site. By following this tutorial video, you will have your WordPress site set up in as little as 10 minutes. At the end of this video, you will have your WordPress site successfully started. The first step I'm going to cover is how to choose and register your own domain name for free with Bluehost, along with providing you with a discount on their hosting. Step 2 is choosing the right hosting plan. Step 3 is getting your WordPress site set up. If you don't have time to start your website or blog right this second, be sure to bookmark this video so you can come back to it later. I provided a link to Bluehost below in the description to get your free domain name and hosting discount. I do want to mention that the link is an affiliate link, and I'll receive a commission which helps support this channel and helps us put out more WordPress tutorial videos. Some things to know about Bluehost is they host over 2 million websites worldwide and over 850,000 blogs around the world. They are also recommended by WordPress themselves since 2005. They instantly install WordPress for you, which makes starting a site that much easier. They provide 24/7 support via chat, email, and phone, and they have a 30-day money-back guarantee. If for any reason you are unhappy, you can cancel and get a refund, no questions asked, within the first 30 days. The first thing you want to do is head on over to Bluehost via the link in the description if you already have it. You'll see the Get Started Now button on the page. Click the button. This is where you can select your hosting plan. You'll see three different options. You'll see a basic plan, plus plan, and a prime plan. I recommend going with the basic plan, and then you can always scale up whenever you'd like. If you have more than one website, then you want to choose either the plus plan or prime plan. I'm going to choose the basic plan for this tutorial, as this is most common. Go ahead and hit the select button on whichever plan you would like to use. We are now brought to a domain page where we can choose a domain name that we want completely free, or if you already have a domain name, you'd enter it in over on the right. For the new domain, you can select if you want it to be a .com, .net, .org, etc. .com is the most popular domain extension, so I'd recommend going with a .com if you can. I'm going to type in a domain and click the next button. You are now brought to a Create Your Account page. This is where you will input your information. We have first name, last name, business name, your country address information, and then you can put a phone number, and lastly, the best email for you, as you'll get email to receipt of payment and a copy of your login credentials, etc. Below that, you'll see package information. You'll see account plan. This is where you can select the term for your hosting package. You have 12 months, 24 months, 36 months, and 60 months. As you can see, you'll save money the longer you purchase your hosting for. I'm going to select the 12 months package. The setup fee is free and the domain is free. You'll see Site Backup Pro. You can unselect this as there are free backup plugins you can use for your WordPress website. Search Engine Jumpstart you can keep unselected. This isn't necessary to have. SiteLock Security Find is security for your WordPress website and protects it from hackers. I'd unselect this as there are really good free alternatives. Domain Privacy is an add-on that I highly recommend. It will prevent telemarketers and marketers getting a hold of your personal contact information and bugging you with their services. The domain privacy will show Bluehost information for the site and not yours. All these add-ons are completely optional and up to you to get. As you can see, you're saving a lot for this hosting package. Below that, you will input your payment information. I'm not going to fill this out for protection of personal information. Once your information is filled in, you want to select the I have read and agreed to Bluehost privacy policy in terms of service. Now click the submit button. You are now brought to a page where you will choose a password for your Bluehost account. Click the create your password button, input the password you would like. Click the I have read and agreed to Bluehost privacy policy in terms and conditions and click the next button. you'll be directed to a congratulations page. Click the blue login button to log in to Bluehost. Bluehost is also going to, at this time, email your dashboard login information to the email address you provided. You will now see Pick Your Theme. Bluehost has a bunch of awesome free WordPress themes to choose from. You can select a theme now if you want to, or below the themes, you can click Skip This Step. If you choose a theme now, you can always change the theme you pick without any problem at a later date. I'll be going over this in more detail later in the video. Once you choose your free theme, you'll be at the page here stating All Done. Click the button that says Start Building to start building your blog or website on WordPress. Once you click that and log in, you will be at the WordPress dashboard. This is what the WordPress dashboard looks like. It'll ask you a few questions, as you can see. If you don't need help, just click the You Don't Need Help option. Once you do that, you will see this page. You will see blog posts, where you can add new blog posts. You will see where you can add new pages to your blog. If you want to change your navigation menus, you can do so easily. And if you are going to sell products on your site, you can install WooCommerce to do so. On the far left, you will see tabs. Hover over them and get to learn them. Post is where you can add new posts. Pages is where you can add new pages. The media tab is where your images will show that you upload to your blog. Comments is where you can view comments people leave on your blog. Appearance is where you can change the look of your theme or change your theme to another one or a premium theme. Select themes. When you hover over appearance, it will showcase free WordPress themes that you can choose from. If you select most popular, it will show you the most popular free WordPress themes. Hover over a theme and click activate to make the theme your WordPress theme. You should also see add new theme on this page. This is where you can add a new theme if you got it from another site or it is a premium theme. In the top left of your WordPress dashboard, you will see welcome here or your site title towards the top of the page. Click this to view your site. To log into your WordPress dashboard, you can do so via the Bluehost cPanel or by typing in your domain name with a / wp-admin. Here's an example. It'll bring up this page here. Just input your login credentials to be logged into WordPress. This is what the Bluehost cPanel looks like. You'll see here you can log into WordPress from it. Over on the left-hand side, you can click the My Sites, which will pull up your current WordPress sites, along with other awesome things in that menu. A great resource I have used for several years and recommend for professional WordPress themes that look like an award-winning design agency did your blog or website is ThemeForest. This is their site here. If you go to the navigation menu and hover over WordPress, you can select popular WordPress themes or themes in a specific industry. You can also type in your industry with WordPress after it to browse premium WordPress themes related to your search. Definitely check this site out. Another great resource that is helpful and used by thousands of website or blog owners is the freelancing platform, freelancer.com. I provide the link in the description as well. Check them out. You post a task or your project for free, and freelancers all around the world bid on your project, and you decide who you hire. You can pay them via hourly or per project. You can get tasks completed for as low as $10, no matter what it is. I definitely recommend you give this site a look. Another great resource to check out is Fiverr. I provided the link in the description below. You can get almost any task done for just $5. And that is my Bluehost WordPress tutorial for beginners step-by-step video. If you have any questions, get in touch, as I'm here to help you with anything you need. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more WordPress video tutorials. Leave us a comment. We would love to hear from you.